teeming with visual charms. Primal sounds. The faces, the eyes, the soft smiles. From Namibia. Sultry, beautiful, enchanting. Stay with us for 120 minutes of spectacle and the crowning of Miss Universe 1995.
From exotic Namibia, the 1995 Miss Universe pageant, with your host, Entertainment Tonight's Bob Goen, your co-host, MTV's Daisy Fuentes, the reigning Miss Universe, Sushmita Sen, and special musical guest, John Cicada.
Here are the 82 contestants for the title of Miss Universe 1995, with their scores from the preliminary competitions. We begin the Parade of Nations with the señoritas from South America. First, Uruguay.
My name is Sandra Smidarik, and I come from the land of the gauchos, Uruguay.
Paraguay.
I am Bettina Barbosa, representing the beautiful Utacaraí Lake Country of Paraguay.
Chile.
My name is Paolo Falcone, and I come from the land of the Andes, Chile.
Peru.
From Lima, Peru, the heart of the Incan Empire, my name is Paola de Lepiane.
Colombia.
I'm Tatiana Castro, proudly representing the world's finest coffee land, Colombia.
Ecuador.
My name is Radmila Pancic, I come from the land where the hemispheres meet, Ecuador.
Bolivia.
My name is Sandra Rivero, I come from the heart of South. Share love with the world, Bolivia.
Brazil.
My name is Renata Bess. I come from the hash of the Amazonia forest, Brazil.
Venezuela.
From Zulia, Venezuela, the land of the love song. My name is Benita Floral.
And now the delegates from the island, beginning with Guam.
I am Aaliyah Stevens, representing the spectacular and friendly island of Guam.
Northern Marianas.
I am Kara Kirschneider, proudly representing the beautiful 14 islands of the Northern Marianas.
Aruba.
I am Maria Denise Hairline from the tourist paradise of Aruba.
The Dominican Republic.
I'm Fenita Lara. I come from the land where culture reaches your heart, Dominican Republic.
Trinidad and Tobago.
I'm Arlene Peterkin, and I hail from the oh-so-beautiful twin islands of Trinidad and Tobago.
Bonaire.
My name is Alan Lampu. It's my honor to represent the Diver's Dream in the Caribbean, Bonaire.
Puerto Rico.
I am Desiree Lowry, representing the shining star of the Caribbean, Corozal, Puerto Rico.
The Cook Island.
The people, the pride of Polynesia. From the South Pacific, I'm Teresa Brown of the Cook Islands.
From Curacao, the unhappy and sunny island, I am Marushka Janssen.
Turks and Caicos.
I am Charlene Brand, representing the peaceful coral of the Caribbean, the Turks and Caicos Islands.
The Cayman Islands.
From the crystal blue waters and white coral beaches of the Cayman Islands, I'm
Anita Bush.
The British Virgin Islands.
From Nature's Little Secret, the British Virgin Islands, I am Elaine Patricia Henry.
The Bahamas.
Representing 700 islands of exquisite culture, I am Shemaine Lindsay, Miss Bahamas.
Mauritius.
I'm Priscilla Mardi Mutu, and I come from the peaceful island of paradise, Mauritius.
The Seychelles.
Representing the Seychelles, the pearl of the Indian Ocean, I'm Maria Payet.
Jamaica.
From Kingston, I'm Justine Willoughby, representing the land that moves to the beat of reggae, Jamaica.
The U.S. Virgin Islands.
From the land of beauty and culture, I am Kimber Shelter, Miss U.S. Virgin Islands.
Now, meet the contestants from Central and North America, starting with Costa Rica.
I am Leticia Alvarado. I come from the land of peace and brotherhood, Costa Rica.
Belize.
From the land of the jaguar and the Munda Maya, I am Deborah Wade from Belize.
The USA.
Celebrating 75 years of the women's right to vote, from the USA, I am Chelsi Smith.
Guatemala.
My name is Indira Chinchilla. I am from the eternal spring land, Guatemala.
Panama.
My name is Michelle Sage, and I come from the tropical isthmus, Republic of Panama.
El Salvador.
I'm Eleonora Carrillo, and I come from the gentleman of the Americas, El Salvador.
Canada.
From the land of the maple leaf, I'm Lana Buckberger, representing Canada.
Mexico.
From the land where the optimism lives in our hearts, I am Luz Maria Cetina from Mexico.
And Nicaragua.
Representing the land of lakes and volcanoes, my name is Linda Clerk from Managua, Nicaragua.
Next, the delegates from Europe and the British Isles, beginning with Norway.
I am Lina Sandvik from the land of the fjords, mountains, and the midnight sun, Norway.
Switzerland.
From the land of the Alps and great chocolate, Switzerland, I am Sarah Brigge.
Portugal.
From far, wild Alf, I am Adriana Iri, and I am representing Portugal.
Sweden.
I am Petra Holtzfeer, representing the Nobel Prize country of Sweden.
The Slovak Republic.
I come from Slovak Republic in the heart of Europe, and my name is Nikoleta Mesarošová.
Great Britain.
From Nottingham in the heart of Sherwood Forest, I am Sarah Jane Southwick, proudly representing Great Britain.
Denmark.
From Aalborg, I'm Tina Dan, representing the home of the Little Mermaid, Denmark.
The Ukraine.
I'm Irina Chernomask from the rich agricultural country of Ukraine.
Ireland.
My name is Anna Marie McCarthy, and I come from the beautiful green island of Ireland.
Iceland.
My name is Margaret Kulov of the Chamber, representing the land of glaciers and lava, Iceland.
France.
From the French Hainan Island, my name is Laurette Curry, and I'm representing France.
Estonia.
My name is Eleha, and I'm representing the natural beauty paradise of Estonia.
Germany.
My name is Eleha. I represent the birthplace of pageant in Germany.
Poland.
From Poland, where the mountains meet the sea. My name is Magdalena Pentiewicz.
Hungary.
I'm Andrea Harshani. I come from the land of the Blue Danube, Hungary.
Finland.
I am Heli Pirhonen, and I come from the land of a thousand lakes, Finland.
Bulgaria.
From the land of the roses, my name is Brianna Dimitrova, representing here Bulgaria.
Romania.
I am Monica Grosu, and I come from the land of mysterious Dracula, Romania.
Russia.
From Moscow, I'm Yulia Nikseva, representing the land of strong people, Russia.
The Netherlands.
From the land of tubes, my name is Hans Alvoes, representing the Netherlands.
And the Czech Republic.
I am Eva Kotulanova. I come from beautiful country in the center of Europe, Czech Republic.
Now, say hello to the delegates from Asia and the lands down under, starting with Thailand.
From Bangkok in the Golden Kingdom of Thailand, my name is Paudi Wishinlath.
Australia.
From the white sandy beaches of Australia's Gold Coast, I'm Jacqueline Shooter.
Hong Kong.
My name is Halina Tam. I come from the economic heart of Asia, Hong Kong.
Indonesia.
From the 13,000 spectacular islands of Indonesia, I am Susanti Manuhutu.
New Zealand.
My name is Shelley Edwards. I come from the land of the long white cloud, New Zealand.
Taiwan, the Republic of China.
My name is Zhang Yiliang. I come from Taiwan, Republic of China.
Singapore.
From the land of racial harmony, I'm Tunisa Abdullah, representing Singapore.
Korea.
I'm Han Song-jun. I come from the land
of morning call, South Korea.
Japan.
My name is Narumi Saki. I came from the land of the cherry blossoms, Tokyo, Japan.
Malaysia.
From Kuala Lumpur, my name is Suzila Azrai, and I'm representing the multiracial land of Malaysia.
India.
I'm Monkey Brar from the country that believes that its people are its most valuable resource, India.
Sri Lanka.
I'm Shivani Bascom, coming from a multilingual and multi-religious country of Sri Lanka.
And the Philippines.
From Manila, I'm John Santos, and I represent the tropical haven of Asia, Philippines.
And finally, we meet the ladies from the Mediterranean, the Middle East, and Africa. Starting with Italy.
I am Alessandra Meloni from the beautiful Mediterranean Highland, Sardinia, Italy.
Spain.
My name is Maria Reyes and I come from the land of the sun, rich in culture and beauty, Spain.
Malta.
My name is Sonia Massa and I am representing the Mediterranean Islands nation of Malta.
Cyprus.
From the birthplace of Aphrodites, the goddess of beauty, I am Clara Rainbow representing Cyprus.
South Africa.
From the gold capital of the universe, South Africa, I am Augustine Masilela.
Kenya.
From a country of love, peace and harmony, I'm Josephine Batia from Kenya.
Turkey.
I am Gamze Saygı. I come from a country of natural beauties in our region, Turkey.
Israel.
My name is Yana Kalman and I'm proud to represent the smallest but the very rich history, Israel.
Greece.
I am Helen Babayanu and I come from the birthplace of Western civilization, Greece.
Nigeria.
From the giant of Africa, Lagos, Nigeria, my name is Tony Raji.
Egypt.
From Cairo, I'm Nadia S, representing the land of ancient wonders and modern progress, Egypt.
Zambia.
From the smoke and thunder of Victoria Falls, representing Zambia, I am Luopuna Bantu.
And Namibia.
Patricia Bird representing Namibia.
We come all over the world to Africa. Exotic Namibia. In the land of the old common land of the poison, Namibia.
Two of the most beautiful women in the world. Our live competition from beautiful Namibia begins as we reveal the 10 semifinalists for the title of Miss Universe 1995, right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host for the 1995 Miss Universe pageant, Bob Cohen and Daisy Wales.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody.
Yes, good evening, everybody. Weren't they just absolutely fabulous?
You girls are beautiful.
You're great.
Oh. Yeah, something else.
One more question, you guys. Doesn't he look absolutely fabulous? Oh,
I'll take that as a no. Well, it's a Reddit tux. It's okay. Doesn't she look great? She looks better than I do.
Well, thank you very much.
You ought to be back there with them.
Enough of that. Let's just do the show.
Okay. Thank you and welcome to the 44th annual Miss Universe pageant. Thanks for being here tonight. We are coming to you live from the Windhoek Country Club Resort in Windhoek, which is the capital of Namibia in southwestern Africa.
Do you know that I learned to say something in Afrikaans?
No, what?
Okay, here do goes. It. Namibia is a onvergetelijke land. You were laughing! Hey, I could say that in Spanish better than you can, okay?
I think you did it right. Whatever. What was it?
What's I think I said Namibia is an unforgettable country.
Is that right? Is that it? Or words to that effect?
Come on, I tried. Right. Anyway, Namibia is a country that's every bit and as beautiful and diverse as our delegates. And Bob, this may actually be a first. This country's even younger than they all are.
You know, that's true because Namibia just gained its independence in 1990. Congratulations to you. That's great. It happens at the same time that women are becoming more independent all over the world.
That's right.
Right.
And as we learn more about our delegates, you'll see just how well they represent the new prominence of women in today's world.
Speaking of prominence in the world, a little bit later on in our show, we are going to have a great musical number from one of today's hottest international singing stars. You're going to love
it. That's right. Ladies, can you handle this? I've got two words for you. John Secada.
John Secada is going to be here tonight.
Hey, they didn't cheer like that for you.
They knew the tux was rented, I guess.
Yeah, well. Anyway, in just a few moments, we'll reveal the 10 semifinalists for the title of Miss Universe.
Now, in tonight's events, beauty does not simply mean physical beauty. It represents mind and spirit and values and ideas. And tonight, we are going to bear witness to those ideals, along with their incredible sense of style and fashion for these wonderful women.
That's right. But first, we'd like to introduce a young woman who really understands the privilege and responsibility of representing the world we live in. So please welcome the reigning Miss Universe, India's Sushmita Sen. Hi there.
You look great.
You look beautiful, as always.
So do you. You look absolutely beautiful, and he looks very handsome.
It's a rented tux. Did I mention that?
Anyway, Sushmita, tell us, has your year as Miss Universe been everything that you expected?
Daisy, it's been an incredible year. I've met some wonderful people, made some great friends. I've worked for my mission of sustainable population growth and traveled around the world. And tonight, as I give away my crown, I'm really looking forward to what the future has to hold for me.
Oh, and I can only imagine it's everything and more.
You've been a great ambassador to the world,
Sushmita. You've done a great
job.
Thank you
so much.
We're going to miss you.
Yeah.
We're gonna miss
you. So?
Anyway, Bob. Sushmita and I are going to head on out of here because I've got to take our viewers on a little safari, so to speak.
Right.
You see, I'm going to be pointing out the scores for them and letting them in on the inside scoop. So you're on your own for a little while,
all the backstage stuff. Thanks a lot. Ladies and gentlemen, Daisy Fuentes and Miss Universe 1994, Sushmita Sen. And now, somewhere in this group of extraordinary young women behind me are the 10 semifinalists whom the judges have chosen to continue in tonight's competition. Earlier during the Parade of Nations, you saw their scores from the preliminary events, and now I have the names of the delegates with the top 10 scores. I'm going to read these names in random order, ladies. The first semifinalist for the title of Miss Universe 1995 is Miss Colombia, Tatiana Castro de Chavez.
She's been up for the past 3 years, and Tatiana makes no secret about it. She's here to win.
Miss South Africa, Augustine Masalela.
Augustine is a TV anchor, so if anyone has the poise to take this pressure, she does.
Miss Canada, Lana Buckberger.
Lana has lived all over the world and has pen pals everywhere cheering her on tonight.
Miss Trinidad and Tobago, Arlene Peterkin.
All right, look at her. Arlene has a smile that could light up the entire African continent, and a lot of people think she could take it all.
Our fifth semifinalist is Miss Puerto Rico, Desiree Lowry.
And sewn inside her dress is a pendant her grandmother gave her good luck, and I'd say so far it's working.
All right, ladies, we're halfway there. One more spot up here belongs to Miss Dominican Republic, Candida Lara.
Candida is a model, and she's definitely the fashion plate of the group, so it's no surprise to see her up there.
Miss India, Manpreet Rao.
The reigning Miss Universe is from India, and no country has ever won 2 years in a row, so the pressure will really be on Manpreet tonight.
Miss Venezuela, Janessi Floriano.
Now, she's modeled since she was 13, and the camera loves her. And Venezuelans always do well, so look for Denisa to be very strong.
Only two spots remain. One of them belongs to Miss El Salvador, Eleonora Carrillo Armani.
Eleonora's brother flew in yesterday from Italy to surprise her, and he's in the audience right now cheering his sis on.
And one final spot, one last chance to become Miss Universe 1995, and that chance belongs to Miss USA, Chelsi Smith.
Wow, now the last time an American won Miss Universe was back in 1980, but a lot of people think Chelsi has a very good chance tonight.
There they are, ladies and gentlemen, the 10 semifinalists for the title of Miss Universe 1995. Stay with us. The semifinals begin with the Jansen swimsuit competition when we return. We are back now with our live show from exotic Namibia, where it is actually a little bit after 1 o'clock in the morning on Saturday. And we're ready to begin this evening, or I guess this morning's competition. The hundreds of millions of people who are watching all over the world are already busy trying to pick their winner. So why not meet the 10 people who really are going to choose the new Miss Universe? That's our panel of judges. And as they're introduced, audience, please, would you hold your applause until all 10 of our judges are introduced? Daisy, help us out here, would you?
You got it. Our first judge was in the film Clear and Present Danger, and her solo album The Love Show will be released on Geffen Records this September. She's Ann Magnusson. This internationally known actor in theater, film, and TV began his career in his native South Africa with Tony Award winner Zakes Mokai. She's one of Latin America's most popular young actresses and a recording star with gold and platinum albums. It's Mexico's own Lucero. He portrays Rock Hudson in the upcoming miniseries Liz, the Elizabeth Taylor Story, and starred on the international hit The Bold and the Beautiful. It's Dan McVicker. Her new single, Peace in the World, is a smash in the USA. She's the entertainer and political activist known as the Russian Madonna, Natasha Alexandrovna. An entertainment writer and associate editor of showbiz trade journals Variety and Daily Variety is journalist Phil Gallo. She currently stars in the CBS TV series Under One Roof and appears in the new feature film Crimson Tide with Denzel Washington. She's Vanessa Bell Calloway. A veteran of theater and more than 70 film and TV roles, he co-stars in the upcoming Whoopi Goldberg film, T-Rex, actor Peter Kwong. After winning the crown, she took a degree in political science and is the first Miss Universe ever to be mayor. Miss Universe 1981, the mayor of Chacao, Venezuela, Irene Saez. He has a European recording contract and released his first single in January. Welcome Namibia's best-known vocalist, Freddie Taylor. Ladies and gentlemen, our panel of very accomplished judges. So here's what's going to happen. The judges will be entering scores ranging from, 1.0 to 9.99 into their computer terminals. You folks at home will then be seeing those scores on your screen. The computer then throws out the highest score and the lowest score and averages out the rest. By the way, there's going to be a test on this later, so I hope you're writing this down, okay? At the end of the semifinals, each contestant's scores for the swimsuit, interview, and evening gown competition are added together. And the top six composite scores determine the six finalists. So what you're about to see is the first event to begin narrowing the field to only six delegates. Bob?
Thanks a lot. And what better way to begin the evening's events than with the Jansen swimsuit competition? You know, grace and fitness are important qualities for a Miss Universe candidate, and our judges are going to be keeping that in mind. The delegates will be wearing shoes from Payless Shoe Stores, and as they compete, each of them will tell you a bit more about herself. Let's begin with Miss Colombia.
I'm part Palestinian, part Jewish, part European white. They all got intermixed with Colombian Indians and blacks. So I believe each of those races and me deserves equal rights anywhere in the world.
Miss South Africa.
When I see other people doing things, people like Nelson Mandela, for instance, it really motivates me as a person because I look up to them and I say to myself, if that person can do this, then why can't I?
Miss Canada.
I refer to Canada as a culture mosaic because we allow for all cultures and races to exist side by side.
Miss Trinidad and Tobago.
I have a huge appetite. The girls around here, they've just been laughing at me. At breakfast, I start out with, fruit. Then I go to yogurt, pancakes, waffles, sausages, you name it. I love food.
Puerto Rico.
Even though I've lived in Puerto Rico for the past 22 years of my life, I learned my English from my father, who's from Oregon, and he forced me to speak in English to him, and I guess I picked up the American accent from him.
Miss Dominican Republic.
When I meditate, it just gives me peace within me, and it just makes me feel good as a person.
Miss India.
I consider myself more of a human than just a girl or a woman. It's excellent to talk about all this, about women's rights and all, which is needed today. But at the same time, we must remember that first and foremost, we're all humans.
Miss Venezuela.
Cuando pienso en mi madre, me siento optimista.
From my mother, I get my strength. As a young widow, she had to be both mother and father to my brother. With so much responsibility, she still managed to see to it that we got our education and plenty of love.
Miss El Salvador.
Much has changed for women in El Salvador as a result of the war, and many women have careers outside the home. I myself leave in August to begin studying medicine.
And Miss USA.
I do work out and try to eat right. To me, a woman's body is a major part of her femininity. It deserves to be cared for and celebrated.
Ladies and gentlemen, 10 of the most beautiful and fit young women in the world.
Of course, we'll recap those 10 scores and see who leads after the first semifinal event in just a moment. But right now, you're about to be transported on a magical Namibian adventure.
A new nation on the Atlantic coast of Africa.
At Sources Play, the world's highest sand dunes grace Namibia, the jewel of Africa.
Excitement is sweeping the country.
Miss Universe has arrived. Follow our travelers on their quest to meet the new queen.
There's beauty in the air, everywhere,
everywhere,
everywhere.
Enticing images lead them on.
Mirages in the sculptured desert, visions in the shimmering dunes, an oasis beckons.
Illusions float like shadows in Namib, the Earth's most ancient desert. Hills of gold meet the sea at Wolfish Bay. And south at the Great Dunes, the blue waters of the Karas Lodge bring a glimpse of dreams to come.
The journey through this land must continue.
Beyond one of the world's largest canyons.
A unique landscape of riches and unexpected fantasies.
Travelers come from afar to see the historic capital, Windhoek, and Namibia's many fascinations, her diverse and independent people, sparkling literates on the Diamond Coast, the thrill of safari. Panorama at Oropoko Lodge.
A moment to rest and enjoy Namibia's southern sun. And the journey continues as new mysteries await.
And we'll have the further adventures of our travelers a little bit later on in the show. But right now, here are those very important numbers, folks. The scores for the swimsuit competition. And, wow, we've got USA leading off. But you know what? That doesn't really surprise me because she won the preliminary competition against all of the 82 delegates. And if you also notice, all these numbers are pretty close together. They're all in the 50s. She's got quite a lead on everybody else. So she's definitely won. Of course, Jensen will award the winner, Miss USA Chelsi Smith, a $1,000 prize. Now remember, this is the first of the three semifinal events, and the scoring lead may change after the interview and the evening gown competitions. In fact, the interview competition is coming up, so here's an idea. Why don't you stay with us and just get to know our delegates a little bit better, okay? That happens right after this. Broadcast from Namibia in southwestern Africa. Right now, here's some of that behind-the-scenes information I promised you earlier.
The international press photographers covering the pageant choose Miss Photogenic. And this year, the winner of the $1,000 award and trophy was Miss Sweden, Petra Hultgren. The Vibrant's Most Beautiful Hair contest was judged by Helene Curtis hair care experts for shine, healthy appearance, bounce, volume, and softness. Miss Peru, Paola de Jepiane, won the $1,000 award. Each delegate votes for her favorite in the Miss Congeniality competition, and the young woman who won the honor this year is Miss Nigeria. She receives a $1,000 award and a Miss Universe trophy.
And congratulations to all of the winners. Right now, check out Bob with the semifinal competition.
All right, Daisy, thanks a lot. You know, it is an extraordinary experience to meet young women from 82 nations around the world at this pageant. Right now, we have the opportunity to get to know 10 of them just a little bit better. Our interviews are spontaneous and they're unrehearsed, and for those delegates who have requested them, we have interpreters from International Data Solutions standing by. Let's begin with Miss Colombia. From Bogota, Tatiana Castro Abashabi is 21 years old. She is a painter, she is a poet, and as Miss Colombia, has been writing a weekly newspaper column. Now, I know besides the column, you've also graced a lot of magazine covers in Colombia, haven't you?
Yes. In fact, that happens when you are a figure, a public figure in my country.
I know you're a public figure. Let's take a look at one of those magazine covers. Do we have it? Now, I like that. Now, who's that guy with you?
Well, he's Kafir. He's my dog. Kafir means, it's a precious stone that means quality and harmony.
He's your dog? They didn't use an actor dog on that?
No.
Really? Did he sit still okay?
Well, he's huge, but he's okay.
Now, I know you're pretty big in Colombia. You have all these magazine covers. How can you improve on all that lifestyle if you should win Miss Universe?
Helping people as much as I can.
All right. Thank you very much, Miss Colombia. Step right over here. That is Tatiana Castro Abachave. Next up, we have Miss South Africa. Augustine Maselela is 26 years old. She speaks 8 languages. She writes a beauty advice column. And she hosts a weekly primetime television show called Prospects. What kind of a show is Prospects?
Well, it's a magazine program which focuses on arts, technology, and tourism. And we visit a lot of places where we cover those places as tourist attractions.
And how long have you been doing the show?
It's been 4 years now.
You like it?
Enjoying it very much.
I bet you've done a lot of stories in those 4 years, haven't you?
Yes, I have. I've covered one of the most interesting ones was the inauguration of the state president in my country, Mr. Nelson Mandela, which was a very emotional moment. But I really, really enjoyed it because it was the first time ever for me to see a president being inaugurated. And it was a very emotional moment. And I couldn't help but became ecstatic.
A lot of changes in your country. Congratulations, Miss South Africa. Augustine Maselea. Now we have Miss Canada. She is Lana Buckberger. She is 20 years old. She is from Calgary, Canada. But listen to this history. She was born in Singapore. She has lived in Malaysia. She has lived in Abu Dhabi, in Dubai, and one of my favorite places in the world, in Pebble Beach. I don't know how that one fits in there with all the other exotic locales. How come all the exotic globetrotting for you?
Well, my father was in the oil patch, and he was transferred around quite a bit, so I had all the opportunity to live around the world.
What is oil patch? I've never heard that term.
He was a superintendent of an oil rig.
So what's patch?
It's just a saying.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm new here, okay? Now, it was kind of an interesting childhood, I'm sure, but kind of difficult to adjust in every new city.
It wasn't so difficult. I think you acquire certain aspects and characteristics that help you adjust and adapt to certain cultures.
If you had children, would you want them to live the same kind of childhood, moving all over the place?
Definitely. Definitely.
Why?
Well, I myself have become a more mature, understanding, and patient individual from traveling around the world. Traveling has given me the privilege to experience different cultures, a wide variety of cultures with different customs, beliefs, and values. And I find that it has taught me to respect each individual themselves as well as their society as a whole. But most importantly, I have definitely grown to become a more mature individual.
Great. Okay. Thank you, Miss Canada. Step right over there, Lana Buckberger. Now we have Miss Trinidad and Tobago. She is Arlene Peterkin. She is 27 years old, currently is a flight attendant with a degree in aviation administration. Boy, she comes from a large family, one of 9 children. And speaking of children, I know that just recently, didn't you go back to like your old grade school and talk to the kids there?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, what happened there?
Well, it was a really rewarding experience because I went back. I got a lot of old memories flowing back into me because the school was very much the same, although it had been modernized. And there was one teacher who was there. She was the kindergarten teacher while I was going to school there, and she's now the principal. So it was really lovely.
What kind of questions did kids that age ask you?
Oh, they asked me, how does it feel to be Miss Trinidad and Tobago? Do you feel like a queen? One of them, I especially remember putting up her hand very eagerly and saying, do you know I have a pet rabbit and her name is Susie? You know, they're very unpredictable because the age group is so wide, you know?
Right.
But it was a lovely experience.
All right. Thank you very much. Miss Trinidad and Tobago, that is Arlene Peterkin. Mm-hmm.
And now we have Miss Puerto Rico. She is Desiree Lowry. She is 22 years old, a recent college graduate who thinks she would like to pursue a law degree coming up next. And eventually she says she wants to work in the field of diplomacy. Now, I heard that earlier you had mentioned that you thought pageants and politics were pretty much the same thing. Is that right?
Well, definitely. I think both of them entail a lot of protocol. Both of them entail having to meet with a lot of people. And I think it has a lot to do with human relations. Pageants are definitely all about learning about different cultures, about learning how to get along. And I think politics has a lot to do with that.
Isn't Spanish the first language of Puerto Rico?
Yes, it is.
You have no accent when you speak English at all.
Well, my father is from Oregon, and he wouldn't speak to me unless I spoke to him in English. So I was kind of forced to learn the language.
I see. Now, they speak English here in Namibia, but they also speak Afrikaans. Do you pick up any of that since you've been here?
Ek is Leifer, Namibia.
Is that, what'd you say?
I love Namibia.
Ah, yes. Oh, the field of diplomacy. Yes. Well done. Okay. Thank you, Miss Puerto Rico. That is Desiree Lowry. All right, ladies, thank you very much. That completes our first five interviews.
Now, do you know that the last time that Canada won was back in 82? Do you feel any extra pressure?
No, I certainly do not. I feel that if I'm just myself here, I'll just do fine.
It's fate from here on in, huh? Miss Puerto Rico, were you good or bad? How did that go?
I think I was good. I don't know. I hope the judges thought so.
You feel comfortable? Oh, that's good. That's a good sign. Now, you're a broadcaster.
Yes, I am.
How would you like to make your worldwide debut here? Because we just don't think you're nervous enough. We'd like to make you a little bit more nervous.
How would I?
Would you like it?
Yeah,
okay,
I would.
Okay, take my microphone and just read from the cue card and give it everything you got.
We'll return with the rest of the interviews right after this from Pert Plus. Shampoo plus conditioner, great hair, no fuss.
Once again, your host, Bob Gold.
We continue now with our semifinalists in the interview competition, and now Miss Dominican Republic. She is 23-year-old Candida Lara. She is from Santo Domingo. She has modeled in Germany, in Spain, in Italy, but currently Candida is studying computer science at Queens College in New York City. You've modeled, you've done computers. What do you hope to eventually do with all this?
Well, I want to finish my career in computer science, be the exclusive model of a famous photographer or a famous designer, and then just work on my family.
Just raise a family?
Yes, build a family.
Really? Right. Now, you're kind of a shopper, aren't you?
A shopper.
Yeah, you like clothes?
Yes. Yes, I love it.
Really? Do you ever want to, like, open a boutique or anything?
Well, actually, I thought about it. There's many other things that I thought about, but, you know, you just got to take things one step at a time.
Yeah. Now, I know since you came here, you have met a very special young man, haven't you? A really young man.
Yes.
Where is he? Where's Quincy? Is he here? Where is he? There he is. There's Quincy. Yeah, that's your special young guy. What's the deal with Quincy?
He's just a very good friend of mine.
Quincy, I think you need a stepladder, though. Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Dominican Republic. Step on over there, Candida Lara. Now we have Miss India Manpreet Brar. She is 22 years old. As the daughter of a military officer, Manpreet has lived all over India, but right now she resides in Delhi, where she is working on her master's degree. And I know when you finish your degree, do you know, come on up here, do you know what you want to do when you finish your degree? I know a master's is a lot of hard work.
Well, I plan to do it in human resource development, and the main reason for doing it in that is because I come from a country which has a vast population. With a country like that, if you use that population to your advantage, you're on the road to progress.
Now, it takes a lot of work to get a master's degree, doesn't it?
Well, just one step ahead of a bachelor's.
Well, I know that, but it's still a lot of homework and a lot of studying.
Well, I think you just need to be a little regular with it. And just a little focused, not myopic.
Do you have any spare time, though? And if you do, how do you use it?
I think time management is the key to success. So I do have a lot of spare time, and I spend most of that spare time studying a little bit of graphology, which is handwriting analysis, and I do a little bit of meditation and yoga also in the mornings.
Okay, great. Thank you, Miss India. Step right over here, Manpreet Brar.
Now, Miss Venezuela comes our way. She is Denise Floriano. She enjoys volleyball and traveling. She's 18 years old and a first-year university student majoring in communications. Now, you're 18 years old. Do you consider yourself a woman or a girl?
Teniendo 18 años, ¿te consideras a ti una mujer o una joven?
De mente creo que soy una mujer.
I think I am a woman.
You are a woman. I think you're right, yeah.
Eres una mujer, de acuerdo.
What's that?
Sí, I just translated what
you
said.
Oh, I know what she said. Yeah, she's a woman, all right. So what is going to be next for you?
¿Qué es lo que quieres hacer después de este...?
Después del concurso, continuar mi carrera como estudiante de comunicaciones.
Well, I would like to dedicate myself to my studies. I study to be an information officer, communication officer.
Communication. Do you want to do television? Is that it?
¿Quieres trabajar en la televisión?
Por supuesto. ¿Por qué no vienes tú conmigo a Venezuela y hacemos un programa juntos? Yo creo que nos iría muy bien.
What's going on here?
Of course, she would like to work on television, and she invites you to join her for a program on Venezuelan television.
You and I? Do a show together? Yeah, like they're going to pay attention to me if I'm doing a show with you. Thank you very much. That's Miss Venezuela. Step right on over there. Denise Floriano. Now, Miss El Salvador. Eleonora Corio Alamani is 19 years old. She is from San Salvador. She was valedictorian of her high school class and is going to begin studying Italy this fall. Now, I found out something interesting, that your mother works for a women's rights organization. Is that right?
Yes.
You understand?
Yes, that's right. Yes, I understand.
How does she feel about you doing pageants?
Well, she had a transformation. Before, she had a different idea of beauty contest. But when she saw me through the Miss El Salvador pageant, and she saw that it was not only beauty, but it was something inside. You can do something, a lot of things for the people, especially when you come from a country that there are people that need of you.
Right. Now, I know that you have a special talent. You read palms, don't you? Can you read my palm?
Of course, sure.
Do it. Let's see. All right, here we go.
Well, you have...
I'm going to die, right?
No. You have a very, very long life.
Really?
This is the line of your life, and you have it very, very long.
Yeah?
You seem to be some kind of smart, too.
Some kind of smart. We're not sure which, believe me. Yeah.
And you seem to have, in all your life, two very great loves.
That's right. That's right. My wife and my son. Thank you very much, Miss El Salvador. Stand right over there. That is Eleonora Corio Alamani. And finally, we have Miss USA, Chelsi Smith. She is 21 years old, originally from Texas. She recently moved to Los Angeles, of course, so she could fulfill her obligations as Miss USA. What are you doing as Miss USA?
I do quite a bit of traveling. I do a lot for my sponsors, just traveling to different states and signing autographs and smiling and waving and doing all that fun stuff.
It's fun, though, isn't it?
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of hard work, but it's a lot of fun.
I just saw an article on you in People magazine, didn't I?
Yes, you sure did. A little bit about my life, about what's going on, and about what I'm going to hope to do in the future, and, you know, things
like that.
Do we
have a picture of that? There it is. Yeah, there she is. Yeah, looks very good. You're very athletic, aren't you?
Well, not exactly.
Well, you're hanging from those bars,
well,
okay.
Know, I was trying. Yeah. No, I work out quite a bit, but I was never really an athlete in school, but I do like to work out. I enjoy fitness.
Now, I know, I read in the article that you were very frank about your family background, your separation, there's divorce, there's alcoholism. Now, I know there are kids out there who are watching tonight finding themselves in the same situation. What can you tell them?
Well, just definitely to stay strong. I think probably my philosophy in life is to always love yourself and to respect yourself. And if you keep that in mind, I think you can accomplish anything you want to. And I think I'm hopefully a representative of that.
Okay, great. Thank you, Miss USA. Step right over there, Chelsi Smith. All right, thank you to all 10 of our delegates. That completes the interview competition.
We'll have the interview scores for you when we come back, and also a very sexy romantic musical number. Very sexy romantic, John Segala, so don't miss it. Okay, and we're back. Namibia scores for you, so let's see how the judges rated them. Wow, we've got El Salvador all the way up on top. And you know what? I knew that that palm reading thing would get them. They loved it. Miss USA dropped down to third place. However, if you notice, these two are pretty close together, so she's still one to look out for. All right, folks, check this out. Let's forget about the scores for a little while. This is that moment where we get to listen to some very sexy music to help us forget about everything. Right, Bob?
Right, Daisy, and our delegates and the reigning Miss Universe know just where to find it. Here they are with international singing star John Cicada.
Sakala. You just gotta love them, you know what I mean? Okay, right now it's time to look in on our two travelers as they continue their magical journey across Namibia.
Dawn, a day of new adventures. A ghost town lost to the desert.
Coleman's cup where precious stones once littered the sand and miners lived in luxury.
The spirit of the diamond-rich past still lingers.
The mysterious rock engravings of Tweefontein, 5,000 years old, tell us that the ancient Bushmen knew the spirit of all living things is ever present within. The end of the day's journey, sunset approaches, and each watering hole becomes a circle of magic where a man is one with nature. Okakuyu.
And cast his dreams into the evening fire. Morning brings together all creatures, great and tall. And welcomes visitors seeking adventure. Our travelers know the real adventure lies within. Like a siren, the skeleton coast beckons. Here, the fierce Atlantic sends ships to their doom. It carves white temples in the cliffs. Now the excitement builds. The moment is near. Who will wear the crown?
Well, that's what we'd all like to know. And I certainly hope our young friend makes it here tonight to find out. But right now, I want you guys to stay tuned for the most gorgeous moment of the night. The evening gown competition coming up next.
Back live from the Windhoek Country Club Resort in Namibia, and I have the honor of introducing now some of our dignitaries. First, let me introduce His Excellency, Dr. Sam Nujoma, President of the Republic of Namibia. May I also present the Right Honorable Prime Minister, Hage Geingob and Mrs. Geingob. Let me thank you and all the people of Namibia who have helped to make this evening possible. Your hospitality has been very, very gracious. Thank you. We would also like to welcome the host committee for the 1996 Miss Universe pageant, which is going to take place in Gauteng, Johannesburg, South Africa. Thank you for being here. Now it's almost time for the last event of our semifinals. Please welcome back all of our delegates as they set the beautiful mood for our evening gown competition. We'll be right back. it has been our tradition over the years to choose little girls from the host country to serve as little sisters to our delegates. And we are delighted to introduce you to these girls, the Little Sisters of Namibia. Woman who wears a crown must possess a certain elegance and style, and the judges are going to be seeking those qualities now as our delegates appear in gowns of their own choice in the 1995 Miss Universe Evening Gown Competition. We begin with Miss Colombia. South Africa. Trinidad and Tobago. Puerto Rico.
India. Venezuela. Our evening gown competition and our semifinal. Thank you, delegates, and thank you so much, little sisters, for terrific.
Well, the semifinals are over. We'll show you all of the evening gown scores when we come back. And then we'll also reveal the six delegates who will move up to the finals. So stay with us.
Holy Ghost Africa, fill my soul, Africa. Let me grow all Africa. Fill my soul, Africa. Don't let me go, Africa. Let me grow all Africa. Remember me.
Yeah, I use it as an icebreaker, conversation piece.
Johnson's clean and clear.
Nobody's zitless.
And oil controlling astringent.
I'm not going to lose sleep and not go out over this. Here today, gone tomorrow. I'm just here to ruin your life today. Thing.
Deep cleaning. With a pharmaceutical ingredient no leading astringent has.
Zit. I mean, what's that? Zit.
It actually helps prevent pimples. Skin is clean, beautifully clear, and under control.
Can you handle it?
I can handle it.
Clean and clear and under control.
Weeds keep coming back. Then kill the roots with Roundup. No root, no weed, no problem. Roundup.
What's happening every week all spring at Kmart? The Kmart Spring Break. Everywhere you look, as long as you look in Kmart, you'll find breaks on everything you need.
It's Mother's Day, and Kmart is where you get the breaks on gifts for mom. Save on everything from 14-karat gold jewelry to hanging flower baskets.
What a break! For hundreds of great price breaks all spring, check out the Kmart Circular every week.
Going to Hawaii. Why did I buy a bikini? Wonder what I'd look like sitting.
When you're trying for a certain look.
Putting on suntan lotion.
What else?
Walking.
Help get that look by including Kellogg's Special K. Great toasted taste, 110 calories, and fat-free.
Oh, bikini. Yeah, I'd say that rhymes with aloha.
Kellogg's Special K. Great taste never looks so good.
From Namibia in southwestern Africa. Right now, let's take a look at the scores for the evening gown competition. And here they are. We've got Canada heading off. And if you notice, they've been moving around a lot. And this is the first time in the top three for Venezuela and India. Canada was, I think, number two once before, if I'm not wrong or if I remember correctly. Anyway, the thing to remember is that these scores are now being added to the scores for the swimsuit and the interview competition. And that, of course, will determine the six finalists. We'll find out who they are in just a few moments. But right now, let's see what happened to our young traveler since we last saw him. From Vibrance, the official hair care products of the 1995 Miss Universe pageant, she receives $10,000 plus a year's supply of Vibrance to give our new Miss Universe's hair the strength to shine. Vibrance, available in shampoo, conditioner, and styling products. A shoe lover's treasure trove, a dream collection of dressy, casual, and active footwear for all the important events and fun activities in her life, plus $7,500, all from Payless Shoe Source, the official footwear for the pageant. Doesn't it feel good to pay less? Miss Universe receives exquisite tourmaline and diamond jewelry using 2 carats of diamonds and over 1 carat of tourmalines to portray the dunes, ocean, and wildlife of Namibia. Created and awarded by Herla and Herma Jewelers, Windhoek, Namibia. Jonelle awards her $7,000 and a year's supply of nail care products. Her nails will be forever lovely with Jonelle's famous sculptured French tip kit. The ultimate in beautiful nails made easy for women on the go. It's Jonelle. Miss Universe receives $5,000 plus a year's supply of Jolie de Vogue cosmetics, created especially to enhance individual ethnicity on a global scale. See eyes, lips, and skin come alive with radiant beauty. For women of all ages, it's Jolie de Vogue. Jansen, official swimwear of the Miss Universe pageant, proudly awards our winner with $10,000 plus an exciting wardrobe of Jansen swimwear and sportswear, all from Jansen, whose clean water campaign is dedicated to keeping America's beaches beautiful. From Hawaiian Tropic Sun Care Products, Miss Universe receives a 1 week trip to Hawaii for two. Hawaiian Tropic World Class Sun Protection, available in over 85 countries around the world. Aloha from Hawaiian Tropic. $5,000 and a fabulous array of Exclamation fragrance products. Exclamation lets you make a statement without saying a word. Exclamation, official fragrance of the Miss Universe pageant. Miss Universe receives 2 first-class tickets on South African Airways to any of their worldwide destinations, including New York, London, Hong Kong, Rio, Sydney, and Cape Town, awarded by South African Airways, the international airline for the 1995 Miss Universe pageant. She receives a gorgeous 18-karat gold ladies watch studded with 200 diamonds, awarded by Bertolucci Watch Company, the leader in Italian-designed Swiss classics. The Miss Universe Diamond Signature Brooch, a creation of Hammerman, New York, world-renowned jeweler. Dazzling with over 3 carats of brilliant diamonds, the brooch was designed by Hammerman as a symbol of Miss Universe's global travels in the year ahead. A $12,000 shopping spree at world-famous Flemington Furs, where she'll choose her favorite fine-quality furs, leathers, shearlings, and cashmeres. All the very latest fashions awarded by Flemington Furs, Flemington, New Jersey. Feeling we haven't seen the last of our young friend there. Now, Sushmita, thank you very much, of course, for showing us all those beautiful prizes that Miss Universe will take home tonight. And also I want to ask you, because we're about to find out who the six finalists are, what did this moment mean to you as you stood on stage in Manila last year?
Well, Daisy, it's a moment where you're nervous and you're excited and you really don't know what you're really, truly feeling inside. But it's come down from 80 to 10, and you just hope that you're one of the six.
Well, they're ready on stage, so I guess we're about to find out. Let's go back to Bob.
Okay, thanks, ladies. Yeah, it's true. It's time to move from the semifinals to the finals. Only six of our delegates are going to continue in this evening's competition. These are the six whom the judges have chosen, and I'm again going to read these names in random order. The first finalist for the title of Miss Universe 1995 is Miss Trinidad Tobago, Arlene Peterkin. Miss USA, Chelsi Smith. Miss Venezuela, Denise Floriano. That's three. We have three spots left. One of them belongs to Miss India, Manpreet Raj. Miss Canada, Lana Buckberger. And the last spot belongs to Miss Puerto Rico, Desiree Lowry. There they are, the six finalists for the title of Miss Universe 1995.
All right, the tension definitely goes up a notch here, girlfriend, with the judges' questions. I just want to know what in the world was on your mind when you were doing this last year.
Daisy, you don't want to know. This is like very, very full of tension because you don't know what the judges are going to ask you. At the same time, your mind is competing for an answer.
Right.
And it is it's a place you don't want to be.
No, I would pack up and go if I were that. Anyway, when we come back, the judges will question the contestants and narrow the field to just three. So stay tuned.
Live from Namibia, the Miss Universe pageant continues. Here's Bob Gold.
Okay, our competition continues now live from Namibia with the judges' questions. Now, each delegate a judge's name from this bowl, and they will have 20 seconds to respond to that judge's question. Following that, the judges will consider the answer, but they will also see a video reminder of that contestant competing earlier this evening. Her answer, as well as the judge's overall impression, is going to determine the judge's score. Ladies, remember, all of your previous scores up until this point are now erased. You're all competing on an even footing from here on out, and we wish you luck. Remember, only three of you can continue to the final round of competition. We begin with Miss Trinidad Tobago, Arlene Peterkin. Go ahead, Arlene. Select a name. You've gone with judge number four. That is Dan McVicker. Dan, your question, please.
Hi. If you were to have a son or daughter someday, or both, what's the most important lesson that you would want to teach him or her?
I'm pretty certain I'll be having both because the family is so important to me. The most important lesson that I would teach them is to be true to themselves, because today I think the world is so going so wrong because people are lying so much, to not only to themselves but to everyone else. And as Shakespeare says, this above all, to thine own self be true, and it shall follow as the night the day. Thou canst not then be false to any man.
Thoughts of Miss Trinidad Tobago. Stay right where you are. Let the judges lock in their scores. Thanks, Arlene. Next up is Miss USA, Chelsi Smith. Go ahead. Reach in there, Chelsi, and come up with a judge. It's judge number six. That is Phil Gallo. Phil, your question.
Do you think the world would be a better place if we just had one world government and no separate countries?
No, I don't believe so at all. I think a lot of the separate countries have their own cultures, their own backgrounds, and even though all the governments may not be perfect, I think that the unity of each of the nations is very important. I've met a lot of wonderful ladies from different countries, and I couldn't see them all living in one country. I think each of them are very unique and special in their own way.
All right, Chelsi, stay right where you are. That's Miss USA. Thank you, Chelsi. Now we have Miss Venezuela, Denise Floriano.
Go ahead, select a name out of the bowl. And you have gone with judge number 9. That is Irene Sayers.
If you knew there will be no tomorrow, how would you spend your last day?
Si te dicen que no habrá el mundo mañana, ¿cómo pasarías tu último día?
Lo disfrutaría con todos los seres queridos, con mi madre, con mi hermano, con toda mi familia.
I would spend it with my beloved ones, with my family, with my brother, with my mother, with those that I love.
All right, Miss Venezuela, stay right here. Let the judges lock in their scores for you. Thank you, Denise. Now, Miss India, Manpreet Brar. And reach into the bowl. Come on. There you go. You come up with judge number 2. That is Zakes Mokai.
If you found yourself in a situation where you are being discriminated against because of race, what would you do?
There is a saying that goes, if your back is bent, only then will somebody climb on it. So stand up straight, and nobody will ever climb on your back. That's all.
Thank you, Miss India. Don't go away. Judges want to score. Don't go away. Just hang right there. Okay, now you can go. Thank you very much, Miss India. And now, Miss Canada, Lana Buckberger. A few names left in the bowl, Lana. And you have gone with judge number 1. That is Ann Magnuson.
If you had the chance to start your life over again, would you choose to be a man or a woman, and why?
Well, since I am a female now, I would definitely choose to be a female again. Because there is not one thing in my life that I regret doing, and I do have a motto that does say, you should never stop experiencing life. From experience, you learn to grow. From growing, you learn to give. And by giving, you let others experience life. Thank you very much.
Hey, Miss Canada, the judges want to vote on you, so don't go away. Okay, now you can step on back with the rest of them. And finally, we have Miss Puerto Rico, Desiree Lowry. Go ahead, select a judge. And you have chosen number 3. That is Lucero.
What do you think is the most important invention of the 20th century and why?
I would say mass communication, because if it wasn't for mass communication, 600 million people in the world wouldn't be able to and experience this Miss Universe pageant. And I think that it has united a lot of our countries to be able to learn about them through television, through radio, and I definitely think mass communication is the best invention of the 20th century.
Okay, Miss Puerto Rico. $600 million are watching? Wow, thanks. Okay, I'm back there. That's it. Thank you, delegates. Great job, and thank you, judges, as well.
Okay, now remember, only 3 of them will go on to the final competition, and we're going to find out who the final 3 are as soon as we come back.
Africa, sing, sing, Africa, sing, sing, Africa, let's lose your memory of some of the people's hands and sing.
Welcome back. We come now to a very, very important point in the evening. We began tonight, as you know, with 82 delegates. Now the judges have narrowed the field to the final 3 contestants for the title of Miss Universe. Ladies, you have represented your countries beautifully tonight. Let me just say that. You've done a terrific job. You should be very proud of yourselves. But unfortunately, we can only go with 3 from here on out, and I am going to read these 3 names in random order. Good luck to all of you. The first of the final 3 is Miss India, Manpreet Brar. Miss USA, Chelsi Smith. And the last woman with a chance to become Miss Universe, Miss Canada, Lana Buckberger. There they are, ladies. ladies and gentlemen, one of these three beautiful young women will be the new Miss Universe.
Wow. All right, this is it. The very last round of competition. Coming up, the final question. I mean, imagine yourself up there. Hundreds of millions of people around the world are watching you live, and you have to answer one more question for all the marbles. It's a test of intelligence, poise, and I don't know, just plain nerve. So let's see how they do.
All right, we have three sensational young women up here, but unfortunately, we only have one crown, so we are going to ask one final question. Ladies, I'm going to ask each of you the same question. You'll have 20 seconds in which to answer, and to make sure that Miss Canada and Miss USA don't have an unfair advantage here while I ask Miss India, you two get to go back here into our charmingly Bavarian soundproof booth. So go on back there if you would, and Miss India, step down here with me. I know that we're in southern Africa here, but Namibia was once a German colony, so we have a little colonial architecture, and I think it's kind of fitting. You ready now for the final question? Here it is. If you had the power to do anything you wished to improve the status of women in your country, what would you do?
I would give the women in my country the ability and the right to choose. The right to choose their lives, the right to choose what they want to do in their lives. And only then will they be individuals, and not just mothers, daughters, or wives, but individuals, thinking, living individuals.
Thank you, Miss India. Step right over here, please. Miss USA. Chelsi Smith, same question that Miss India had is, if you had the power to do anything you wished to improve the status of women in your country, what would you do?
Well, actually, I think they have come a long way so far. I do wish that people would look at women as just as they look at all men, just equally in power. I know a lot of women that can do anything that they choose, and I am one of those women, and there are 80 of these women that are here today. So I think that women are doing very well, but I'd like to see people treat them as they should.
Okay, Miss USA, step right over here. Join Miss India, please. And finally, Miss Canada. Lana Buckberger in the soundproof booth, and now you get the same question as the other two women. The question is, if you had the power to do anything you wish to improve the status of women in your country, what would you do?
The status of women in our country, in Canada, my country, right now is already increasing. Right now, more women are graduating from universities. They're making more decisions, ranging from corporate to daily simple operational decisions. I think that I would encourage them to keep on learning. Go and finish your degree and even get your master's. The more education you get, the better off you are. Thank you very much.
Okay, Miss Canada, step right over here if you would. Join the other ladies. That's it. Well done, all three of you. Now, the final moment, ladies and gentlemen, the final moment of the competition. This is the vote. As each delegate steps forward, the judges are going to vote for her to be either the second runner-up, the first runner-up, or the new Miss Universe. And I want to remind our judges and our audience as well that this vote takes into consideration the answers to the final question, as well as the judges' overall impression of the delegate during the competition tonight. So they are choosing the young woman they believe will be the best Miss Universe. We begin with Miss India. Miss USA. Finally, Miss Canada. And that completes our competition for the title of Miss Universe 1995.
Well, the judges' decision has been made. Do you think you know who the winner is? I think I know who the winner is. But you know what? It doesn't even matter anymore, because we're all going to find out when we return and crown the new Miss Universe.
air travel from the Americas, Europe, Asia, Australia, and Africa provided by South African Airways, Africa's warmest welcome, and the official international airline for the 1995 Miss Universe pageant.
The final act of our drama, all ready to unfold here in Namibia, and this is the moment when we must say farewell to the young woman from India who has worn the crown for the past year. Ladies and gentlemen, for the last time as Miss Universe, Sushmita Sen.
What I give away tonight is only my crown. But I'll carry with me for the rest of my life the beautiful memories and the heart full of love that I experienced. I must thank for this moment of glory my motherland, India, and her proud people, my parents and brother, my friends and my school. For these are the people who made me who I am today and helped me realize my dreams. Tonight as I leave, I shall not say goodbye. Because every ending has a new beginning. And this, for me, is the beginning of another dream. So watch out. Here I come. God bless and peace. Jai Hind.
Sushmita, thank you so much. We wish you well in the future.
Thank you also, Sushmita, for sharing your experiences with us this evening. That was great. And you know what, Bob? I gotta tell you, I've had a wonderful time here tonight.
Me too.
Not to mention the incredible time we've had here in Namibia. You guys are unbelievable.
Thank you so much for your hospitality.
Yes.
It's been great. You're a wonderful country with wonderful people, and you've been really giving hosts, and we appreciate it. Okay, you ready to change somebody's life forever?
Well, you know, that's exactly what I'm in the mood for, Bob.
Okay, let's do it. We're ready to reveal a second and first runners-up and the new Miss Universe. The accounting firm of Ernst & Young has revealed the results for accuracy. Mark Ward is here. Excuse me, Daisy. He has the results. Thank you very much, Mark. Okay. Do we have anybody to help?
Yes, we do. As a matter of fact, we've got to assist us. Miss Universe 1992, please welcome Namibia's own Michelle McLean.
And now the second runner-up is Miss Canada. And then there were two. Now, as we're about to reveal the name of the first runner-up in the new Miss Universe, let me remind you of the importance of the first runner-up. You do it,
Daisy. That's right, because, you see, if Miss Universe can't complete her reign for any reason at all, that means that the first runner-up will then become the new Miss Universe.
Here we are, ladies. The first runner-up is Miss India, Chelsi Smith. You are the new Miss Universe! Chelsi, congratulations. Can you believe it? The cash awards, the gifts are yours. You take your place in a very special sisterhood. And we congratulate you and all the delegates for being such beautiful examples of women in the 90s. And now, the stage is yours, Miss Universe, Chelsi Smith. Miss Universe 1995. Next year for the 1996 Miss Universe pageant from Gauteng, Johannesburg, South Africa. And now, on behalf of Daisy Fuentes and the new Miss Universe, Chelsi Smith, this is Bob Bowen saying thank you and good night from Namibia.
Portions of this program have been pre-recorded.